for one of its prime aims, besides the establishment of a unified construction agency, would be able to start without delay on the long-term program of rehabilitation to be undertaken by the Korean people on their own initiative and respect. It is still essential for the free world, as represented in this assembly, to remain united, confident, and calm, sure in the knowledge that aggression in Korea has been repelled. We must continue to stand on the various offers for an honorable armistice already made, in the hope that our opponents will one day see the light and one day agree to cease fighting on honorable terms. During the first part of the assembly, we were told at great length that the Geneva Convention must be fully and scrupulously executed, particularly in regard to the repatriation of prisoners of war. Some of us may well have found such admonitions from the Soviet delegation a little hard to stomach, considering that the Chinese and North Koreans have consistently refused to abide by any of the provisions of the Geneva Convention about the treatment of prisoners. Nevertheless, they now have another opportunity to show whether they are sincere or whether they aren't. I very much hope that they will respond. Our first preoccupation must remain to secure an honorable peace. So long as such a peace eludes us, we have a duty to do all we can to relieve the sufferings of the civilian population and make a start, at least make a start, with restoring the economy of that war-torn country. We stood together in resisting aggression, and we must also stand together in helping the victims of aggression.